Hello and welcome, fellow gamers. My name is Borek and this is another episode of 7 Days to Die. Finally, after this. Yes, we are back. We are back and I've been doing... Look at that, it's already 3 p.m. So, I've been gathering some stuff. I mean, potassium nitrate as well as iron. And I actually got like shit ton of that raw iron. So, let's burn this baby. Since we want to burn as much as possible, because we need a shitload of iron. I actually ran out of coal, and that sucks a bitty. Witty bitty. That should be enough to burn all of those. And probably we will have a screamer on our ass just soon enough to test that, to test the thing that we want to do today. So let me first just make repair the auger. Handlebars, let's repair those. So that's done. Auger parts, we need to repair those, but first I want to repair the auger plate, and I think we can make it in the workbench. We can make new auger blade with forged steel, two forged steel and one repair kit, and use to assemble an auger. If your science skills is high enough, you can recraft and improve it at workbench. So let's do it, and let's see how we will do if it's gonna be done well enough or not. And let's repair those guys as well. I mean the parts, look at that, it actually went down a bit probably, and the science skill is not high enough. 22 crafting quality, I don't get it. So at what level do I need to have my science skills to make it like better? Anyway, well, let's assemble the auger, and we will be using that. We will be using that. Is that all? Yep, that's all. And we will be using it to make a few holes in the underground bunker. Because we want to do it. Right, so in between videos, I've been also making some supports over here. So now I can actually place a roof above our head with white adobe plates. Because this will look like a ceiling pretty much, and I hope it won't collapse. It shouldn't collapse, so that should be a-okay. So now we won't have any rain falling on our heads, and that should be grand. Of course it's gonna take me a while, since I'm building the roof from down below. It would be much faster if I would stand on the roof itself. And as you probably have already seen, I have shitloads of materials in my inventory as well, and I would like to use them to actually finish the ramp with the drone bridge, so that we have a proper entrance to our base. As Josh asked that it would be nice to make an elevator going up our base, such as Z-Nation did, but I think he is using mod for the water, and I don't think I would be able to do it in the vanilla gameplay. I'm trying to keep as vanilla as possible this gameplay. Modded is of course the other series with Valmod, and I'm not planning on doing any other modded gameplays just yet, but we will see how it goes. Right, so we still have, holy shit, why did I made so many? Oh, probably because we will be needing some ceilings over here as well. Right, so here's gonna be the second floor where I will move all my stuff, crafting stuff. Ah, told you there's gonna be a screamer or any other sucker that came here. Who actually came in here? No, nobody important. And I've made myself a little pond over here. Oh, that's just a wandering zombie. Nothing special. Right, now let me just get the doors, because we will be needing doors. Because I want to use them to attract zombies down below to the pit. Right, let me just take a few of the concrete pillars. I have a mix with me, but we might actually take some more mix with us. Right, let me just leave this over here, and let's go downstairs to the pit, and let's see how it goes. because it's day 27 and tomorrow we will have a fun time. Oops, wrong entrance. Oh, I need to build a corridor over here so it looks like a proper base, not just some stupid shaft leading nowhere. But no biggie, no biggie, we will be doing that later on. So the plan of action is, as I said earlier, to have a vault door over here, probably. No, I will build it over here. So this should attract zombies to the ground floor. Oh, look at that, we had the visitor over here. How nice. Well, that was useless, but anyway, it's good that somebody at least came here. Then I will have spikes in here and have the second door right around here. But I've built pillars over here, and that sucks because I actually didn't want to do it because they look like damage, so let's get rid of them. Come on, come on. Ogre is much quicker than even the Ulfei steel pick. It's really hard to, you know, it takes so long to do the things right. So I'm gonna place one door over here, like that. Then I think I will be using the quarter blocks. So let's make 6 of those, then we can place them. Let's place them like so. Okay, and on the other side as well. Of course, we will be upgrading those to real concrete. Shit! God damn it! Why do you always need to make those such things? Right, so the doors are now placed really nicely. Look at that, it looks so smooth and awesome. We have a concrete, so we might actually upgrade those already. I don't think any zombies will be beating on those, so no biggie. But they need to look cool as well. Right, so we have one door over here. Now, how should we... Pillars? Should we go with the pillars? What do you think? Yeah, with the pillars, because it's gonna be much easier to kill the zombies. And one on top of over here. Then like so. Yeah, ran out of pillars. 50 pillars, 50 concrete pillars. Let's make a couple of them. And in the meantime, let's make a proper entrance for the zombies. Oh, this takes a while, to be honest. Even with the order. I know it's a bit loud, and I'm sorry about that, but this is the only way. How can I really quickly remove those? Right, okay, those doors are gonna be placed a bit awkward, but do not worry about that, that's just a for the sake of testing. Right, have I placed those guys correctly? I think so, because I wanted the zombies to be on the outside of the block. That should be enough. And now this should call in all the zombies from the nearest vicinity into the pit. And the pit. Let's upgrade that. And now let's check what's the durability of the door. 8,000. That's good. That's good. That's actually grand. Doesn't look as smooth as I would like it to look, but for the sake of testing, It needs to look like that. The only purpose of this door is to attract zombies down here. Right, so let's finish the corridor like that, and now fighting area over here. Actually, I should increase the height and place some rebar blocks on top of that as well. Don't you think? Do you agree? I hope you do. Because even if the zombies break through here, they need to stay in here, and I don't want them to be roaming around my base like crazy. Right. There should be one, and I think one more higher, just in case, so we can place a concrete blocks as a ceiling. Of course, the ceiling, like so, and then upgrade them to reinforced concrete. Because you know, even if the cop zombie will get down here and blow up, that might be a bit of an issue if he destroys the blocks in here, because everything might actually collapse. I hope it won't, but you never know. You just never know what will happen. Right, one should go over here as well, and that should be stable enough to hold off any zombies that might be in this tunnel. I don't know if they will be able to get to this tunnel, but we will see, of course. Right, and few blocks up here. Just let's just make some room, and that should be enough. And of course, upgrade it, and then the ceiling. And on top of that, we will place some pillars, like that. So the fighting area is done, and I actually might place a spikes over here, as well as on the top. But I will leave the top just for now. Right, what else I wanted to do is actually to check if the spikes, if I remove the spikes, will the zombies get much more fall damage? Because that might actually be a thing. Because I've seen Games for Kicks that he was doing his pit. Oh shit. He did his pit, and the zombies that fell in there actually died. So I was wondering if the spikes are actually acting as hay blocks. That's why I will remove four spikes on the side, because even if the zombies will drop, they should drop right over here. Right over here. Close to that wall. And I might actually place concrete plates to check if that drop is acting as a hay bale or not, and if they will die on the concrete much quicker. It should be much quicker right now. Yes, I do know that I'm taking the trap damage, and probably a zombie or two will fall on my head, but let's not worry about that. Oh, shit, these guys are really so durable. I am impressed. I am impressed. So with the shitload of iron that I got while looking for white powder, I got shitloads of iron, and that should help me. That should actually help me with upgrading all of this to complete steel cage, and that would be so cool. Right, plate. Let's make a few concrete plates. Well, actually, let's make a test. Now, let's focus just on the concrete plate, because concrete... Well, now... If I do plate... Or should I do the whole concrete block? I don't think that it's wise to leave... Well, I must do the testing. Okay. So I will go in here and destroy those blocks, and I will leave two blocks. Two spikes. I will destroy those two spikes. I will destroy those two spikes and leave them be. I mean the bedroom. I will just leave be. And then we'll check if the bedrock will actually kill crawling zombies or not. And over here I will place the concrete plates and concrete blocks. Yeah, that's the plan. Right, so those two will be like so. I will place two of those like that. Just for the test sake. And now two concrete plates. If the concrete plates will work, that's gonna be grand. Because I actually might make a combination of spikes and concrete. Well, we'll see how it goes. Can I go out? Yes. Fortunate. That should be sweet. And now, to top this off, a few more pillars. And that should be done. And actually, I will be placing another door over here, just for the sake of me and staying alive. Even if the zombies destroy the vault doors. Right. Okay, and now here's few blocks that needs to be corrected as well. That will just take a few hits. Fortunately, we have a really high quality steel pick. Look at that, it's almost one hit. I don't think I can make actually the pickaxe high enough to destroy one block with just one hit. It would be so cool, but I don't think it's gonna happen. Right, and a few more pillars over there. Right, so that should be done, and that should work perfect. Oh yeah, and the spikes. We need to place three spikes. Three scrap spikes. So even if they break through, they will get damage by standing on top of those spikes. Or I can kill them easily. And now we can upgrade those up to steel. Huh? Run out of steel. Holy shit. That takes a while. So we'll see how it goes with the concrete blocks. We'll see how it goes with just the bedrock. And we'll see how it goes with the concrete plates, if they do more damage. So I will be standing here, and hopefully that will be enough just to survive. Right, so that's the plan. Do we have a screamer on top? That would be so cool if we would, because we could actually test it. Ah, yes, we do. Hello and welcome. Whoa, 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 let's not drop down. Let's go up. Hello, lady. Where are you? Where are you? Right. Hello. Wrench in the head. Wrench in the head. Okay, that should be enough. Now, let's go on top. And now let's try and lure them into the trap. There should be plenty of disease. Yes, 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 you do the scream. The zombies should rise up again. That's not too many. But okay, let's go downstairs and let's check if that will actually work or not. Oh shit, nothing here. Go to here, to the pit. There is a door that you want to smack open and get my ass. I can even open the doors for you. Yeah, let's do that. Let's check if that actually works. Oh, yeah. Can I open them from here? Hello? Zombies? Probably I will end up placing doors up to the top, so they will get attracted eventually, because I was told that I should place them in the middle of nowhere, because that actually might attract them a bit better. But even... Oh, hello! He actually came to say hello. Right, will anybody else come? Look at him go for the doors. Of course. But he didn't die. Well, she felt on the spikes and she didn't die. Well, I think she felt on... Actually on the rebar. Not rebar. The barbed wire. They are not doing any damage to the door, which is good. Right. So if I'm getting a bit too close, they are eager to get me through the hole. Right. There goes your leg. See you later. Right, so if I open this door, I can let you in. And you can have fun in here. Oh, but there is supposed to be a whole horde up there. Yeah, so he died. Whoops. In the butt. Oh shit, I will probably destroy my whole base before I get her. Yeah, just destroy those guys. Well, I guess I should work on attracting them a bit better. So probably I will just make a shit ton of wooden doors and place them from the inside into the pit. So maybe this way they will be attracted. I don't know. We'll see. We will see. But for now, let's just close this off. Maybe I'm just too deep? I don't know. Maybe I should build like the shark cage. So, as everybody was talking about, I don't know. Well, we'll see how it goes with this setup. Yeah, they are still here. Anyway, guys, I think that's going to be it for today's episode. So, this is my idea for letting in the zombies. Unfortunately, only two just came, but there is a high probability that more of them will come. Oh, look at that go. Right. So I guess not too many zombies actually came in here. That sucks. Maybe now they will come. I will see. So okay, guys, I think that's going to be it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, remember to leave a like, comment about the gameplay, and I hope we'll see each other in the next episode. So till then, take it easy. Have fun and happy gaming. Will you go in? There's the door. No. More doors. I need to build more doors.